I keep thinking this is called Afro, and then I look at it again, I'm like, I can't read. Okay. Hello, people. I am Jaby KOAY, joined by Shah.
Hello.
We're looking at another Prime Video trailer. Mm. This is called Afsos, the official trailer of 2020. I'm sure I'm pronouncing it wrong, but what the hell? We'll keep trying anyway. This is, I don't see any director information in the YouTube description, but there are a lot of names in the title. It's Gulshan, Devaiah, Anjali, Patil, and Heeba, Shah.
Okay.
So 15,000 upvotes, 347 down as of this recording, which is quite strong in terms of favoring the video.
Mm-hmm.
It says, Amazon Prime Video presents Afsos Official Trailer 2020, a new series starring Gulshan, Devaiah, Anjali Patil, Heeba Shah in the leading roles. A suicidal man and a deadly assassin encounter the world of immortality in this black comedy suspense thriller.
Oh.
Comes out January 17th.
That sounds super interesting.
Ek waqt tha jab mujhe lagta tha ki main is duniya mein sabse mahatvapurna insaan. Magar ek baar aasman ki taraf dekho to ehsaas hota hai ki
hum kuch nahi hain.
Inception.
So this was your 11th attempt.
Oh, I like this show.
Wow.
You have to fight back.
किसी किसी का अच्छा और बुरा दिन आता है और जाता है लेकिन मेरी जिंदगी में कोई अच्छा दिन आया ही नहीं है। My life story so poorly written कि मुझे लगता है कि मैंने खुद लिखी है। मनुष्यत्व का और कोई इलाज नहीं है। मुझे मरना ही होगा। जो लोग suicide नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, उनको मारने में कोई इज्जत नहीं है। Guilty feel होता है।
इसमें guilt कैसे? लोग दुखी हैं, मरना चाह रहे हैं पर मर नहीं पा रहे। So we are just assisting them with a solution. कैसे करना?
Shoot.
Shoot. कहाँ?
सर पे ये हो जाएगा।
ये काम उपाध्याय को दे रही हूँ। अब आपको देश की फौज भी नहीं बचा सकती। अगर उसने कोई काम ले लिया ना तो मौत भी नहीं बचा सकती। Now that's an artist.
इस पूरी दुनिया में सिर्फ एक इंसान है जो मुझसे बात करता है। आप
हम पिछले 6 महीने से मिल रहे हैं। We are no longer just another patient for me. कभी सोचा है तुमने कि if you die, how will I feel?
I'm sorry, मुझे नहीं पता था कि मैं आपके लिए इतना important हूँ।
Oh no!
तो आपको अभी नहीं मरना है।
हाँ।
जूते नहीं बेच रहे हैं कि जब मर्जी किया order cancel कर दिया। और एक बार अगर उपाध्याय ने सोच लिया कि तुम मरोगे, तो तुम मरोगे ही।
Wait, what? Is there a supernatural aspect to
this? Yes, because I remember in the blurb it said he encounters a world of immortality. That was cool. That was really, that's such a fresh idea.
Yeah, look at all that shallow depth of field. I'm sorry. I was on a rant in the last video that we just shot for, what was the trailer called?
Disco Raja.
Disco Raja teaser 2.0. I went on a rant at the end about shallow depth of the field, and then there was like some shot.
It was forgivable.
It was forgivable here because she was inside of a van. That's when I noticed it. And it's like, there's not a lot of light in a van. And it's like, you want it to be natural looking, and so you just gotta open up that aperture so you can see her face. Right. The problem is like, when you can't discern what the background is, that's what I hate. The point is to put the person in focus, not to completely blow out the background so you don't know where the person is.
Right.
But anyway, it looks cool. I like the concept. Okay, I didn't mean to start this off in a negative way. I like the concept a lot. I think it's super cool. It's very fascinating. I like the main character. It sort of reminds me of being John Malkovich in a way. John Cusack, who's just like, you know, and that kind of character. But you feel bad for him and you're kind of rooting for him in a way, like, no, don't do it, man, come on. And then he finds love, I guess, or he finds someone who cares for him.
You mean in this or in being?
Yeah.
It's his therapist.
I thought the joke was gonna be, I didn't know you cared about me. Well, I don't, it's because you're my patient, kind of thing. Like,
right.
I didn't know where that was going. I didn't know if she actually had feelings for him or something like that.
I did kind of have a similar feeling. I thought that maybe she was just gonna say, well, of course I care for you, you're my patient. But I think the idea is that now she's actually invested in him, and I don't know if it is as lovers, because that's a breach of professionality right there. Like, you shouldn't fall in love with your patients. But I think maybe it's just like she feels a kinship and a friendship with him, you know, like she actually cares about his well-being.
There's a movie called Thank You for Smoking with the dude who plays Harvey Dent. in in The Dark Knight. Aaron Eckhart? I forget. But in Thank You for Smoking, he's playing a spokesperson for the smoking companies, right? And he goes, we don't want our customers to die. We want them to stay alive and keep smoking. And so likewise here, I'm like, okay, well, of course she doesn't want him to die. Who's gonna, she's paying her bills with his problems.
Oh yeah.
You know?
Wow, that's like a very pragmatic way of looking at it. Not romanticized at all.
But I mean, the thing is, it's deliberately being a bit ambiguous. I wish they didn't show you the part where he dies. That really upsets me that they gave that away in the trailer. I'm assuming that's not just like a weird sequence happening in his head where the blood splats on her face. Yeah. I'm assuming that's where really where he died. And I'm like, oh, you gave so much away. That would have been a surprising moment in the show.
I mean, they already mentioned it in the description here on YouTube. So at first I was like, oh my God, they've just given away the ending. And then I remembered that there's this whole immortality aspect to it. So maybe he dies very early on in the series, because if what they're saying is correct and the assassin is indeed extremely good at her job, it's not gonna take long for her to kill him, right?
I know, but that's like showing the airplane explosion from the movie Always in the trailer. You don't do that. You save it for the movie. Okay, you don't know the story of Always. It's just kind of like this. The dude is a ghost in the movie Always.
Okay.
It's Richard Dreyfuss.
Okay.
Where he dies in an airplane kerfuffle. And then he has to deal with watching his wife move on to another dude.
Oh, okay.
And
gotcha,
he's got to wrestle with that and let it go. That's what the whole movie's about, is him letting that shit go and accepting the next stage of things, right? Well, this goes a different way. He's dealing with immortality. I don't know what the hell's going on there. I mean, obviously, you're right. It's like, this is the inciting incident. When he gets shot, that's the beginning of the adventure.
Yeah.
Right? But they shouldn't show you that moment, because now you're looking for it, right? What they should have done was they cut to black during one of their conversations, not the conversation where he actually gets shot. There was some movie trailer we were watching recently with Surya, and she goes, you're always mad. And he goes, shut up, bitch, and slaps her or something, right? That's not exactly what, that's not what happens, but they cut two different scenes together, and someone pointed it out to me in the comments, and I also like saw it at the same time and realized my own mistake later. Because when you're watching this stuff, it's all flurry. What they should have done was they should have had a conversation or shot something for the trailer that's not that atmosphere, not that scene, and cut to black, gunshot, a bunch of people crowded around or whatever, and you don't know where that is in the story. So when you see it in the show, you're like,
surprised.
It just catches you off guard. You're like, oh shit, what's next? There's a big surprise that happens in the movie Parasite. I'm not gonna say what. It's this like other dimension, let's say. That's a very ambiguous way to put it. There's this other dimension to the movie that you're not expecting.
Yeah.
And if they showed that in the trailer, I would have been so pissed. Because it's such a cool surprise.
Yes,
right?
true.
And so I feel like they should have tried to find, because it's already an interesting concept. I don't know how you would conclude it, because you sort of need this 3-act structure to a trailer. I don't know how you conclude it without showing you this other ghostly element, but I wish they found a way not to. I wish they pitched it to you in such a way that it was almost like, well, this is happening in his head. Right? And you get to the movie and you're like, oh no, like this is the adventure. How cool is that?
Even though we read the description, I immediately dropped it out of my mind as soon as we started watching it. And it was just fascinating to me, this whole idea of maybe the series is him just trying to escape death. Because so far he's managed to escape it when he's tried to kill himself 11 times, right? Maybe the comedy is that every time this person is trying to kill him, she misses, you know? And he's like, woo, close call.
No, I'm pretty sure this is like reverse City of Angels. This is like, he's dead, and he's trying to figure out how to come back. So,
yeah.
You ever see City of Angels?
Yeah, I like City of Angels.
Nick Cage is an angel and kills himself as an angel so he can have be with Meg Ryan, and then she dies, and he has got to go in the ocean and kill himself. That's the whole movie. Spoiler alert. Anyway, yeah, this is a super cool concept. I like the cast a lot. I like all the faces they've chosen, and I'm going to echo something I said just yesterday, which is Amazon's originals are so well crafted. They're so well produced. Save for the fact there's a lot of shallow depth of field in this. It's just very well crafted. I was going on a rant in the previous video about how much I'm tired of like the extremely shallow depth of field where it looks like everything's like at a 1.4 aperture. Like, come on, you can stop down a little bit. Go down to 3.5, go down to 4, something, you know? You don't have to be so shallow, have depth. So that's all, that's a stupid tech rant that no one is paying attention.
No one cares,
unless you're like a movie head like me or like-
You're a cinematographer, maybe a photographer.
I was gonna say like Harsh Vardhan Kapoor, you know, unless you're like-
Cinephile.
Unless you're a cinephile, then you're probably not gonna care. But yeah. Stop with the shallow depth of field, like the super Jesus Christ. Like, you don't need to. All the classic movies that y'all love, like Citizen Kane, doesn't have depth of field that shallow.
This looks awesome.
It does look awesome. I love it.
I think the idea is just so interesting.
And an original.
Yeah, and I love the comedy. I love the comedy. as well. Like, I think my favorite bit was when you just see him and the therapist in the van looking so awkward.
Yeah.
And then they're like, you can't just cancel the order. You've ordered a hit on yourself. This is something you've set in motion now.
Yeah.
And there is nothing you can do about it. And there's like just a sense of doom, but also comedy at the same time.
Yeah, thematically, this reminds me a lot of Being John Malkovich. And like, it's that genre, that weird
black comedy.
Black comedy, yeah. But it's got this weird magical element as well. Because Being John Malkovich has like a magical element to it. I like it. I'm very impressed. You guys, thanks so much for hanging out with us. Be sure to check out ACHARA KIRK and the Jabs on the social media. Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, bell icons.
I thought you said ballet.
No, bell icons. That's not, but these are just like sparkles. Like
sparkles!
4th of July.
Oh my God.
That's what I do when I've got sparkles. I go, oh my God, don't burn me.
Yeah.